Hey guys, welcome to this video. My name is Ron White. I'm a two-time USA memory champion. In this video, if you are a parent and you're trying to teach your children how to memorize the multiplication tables, I'm going to walk you through exactly how I do this when I'm trying to teach someone their multiplication tables. By the way, if you enjoy my teaching style and if you want to get my black belt memory course, which is going to help not just with multiplication tables, but remembering what you read, studying for a test, learning foreign languages, memorizing anything to get better grades as a student, click the link down below in the description, get my free memory gift, and find out about my black belt memory course. Now, let's talk about how to memorize the multiplication tables. If you're working with your child or a student on how to memorize this, it can be daunting. They look at that and they see a 10 by 10 grid. They're like, oh, there's 10 by 10, that's 100 different possibilities there. I got to memorize them. How am I ever going to do this? Well, when we break this down, it's really not as daunting as it seems. Let's take the first one for example. The ones, you don't really have to memorize those, do you? Because one times any number is the number. One times eight is eight. One times nine is nine. So we can kind of cross those off our list. And boom, now we're down to a 9 by 9 grid here. Now, how do we learn the twos? Now, the twos are just a multiplication problem. 2 times 2 is 2 plus 2. If I'm working with a student, I would say, what's 2 times 3? And I would have them understand that 2 times 3 is the same as 3 plus 3. 2 times 4 is the same as 4 plus 4. 2 times 5 is the same as 5 plus 5. And have them say that and have them understand that. Really, you want a student to understand the numbers. You're not wanting them to memorize it. Have them understand that 2 times 6 is 6 plus 6. 2 times 7 is 7 plus 7. This is something about the twos. Then after they do that, have them count by twos. After they really understand that 2 times 4 is 4 plus 4, and you've got them understanding that, then have them count by twos. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. When they can count by twos and understand that 2 times 5 is 5 plus 5, the twos are so easy to learn. So the ones and the twos are so easy to learn. So now we can cross off all of those. Now, right there, we are down to a smaller square that we're trying to memorize. Now we're on to the threes. How would I teach a child to memorize the threes? I use the plus three strategy. So 3 plus 3 is 6. And then I would say to the child, plus three, and they would say 9. Then I would say plus 3, and they would say 12. Plus 3, and they would say 15. I would say plus 3, and they would say 18. Plus 3, and then they would say 21. Plus 3, and they would say 24. Plus 3, and they would say 27. Once you can get them to see the plus 3 strategy, you're just adding 3 to the last one, have them understand it. Remember, understanding is the key here. Then once they understand that, then do the counting real fast again. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30. Have them do the counting fast, and then they've mastered the threes. I always like to just have a middle ground test there and say, what's 3 times 5 then? And they will say 15, because the fives are easy. The fives always end in a 0 or a 5. Now you can cross out all the threes. Now you've crossed off all the ones, all the twos, all the threes, and now you're down to a 6 by 6 square here. This isn't really that daunting if you break it down this way. How to learn the fours. I do it the same strategy as on how to learn the threes. I do this with a plus 4 strategy. I say, what's 4 plus 4? They say 8. Plus 4, 12. Plus 4, 16. Plus 4, 20. Plus 4, 24. Plus 4, 28. Plus 4, 32. Plus 4, 36. Have them understand that you're adding 4 each time. And then once they've gotten real good at that, then maybe you can say, hey, can you count by 4s? 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40. Then I will just sometimes randomly throw in there, what's 4 times 5? And they'll say 20, because again, that's an easy one. It's either going to end in a 0 or it's going to end in a 5. I like knocking the 5s out of the way. Why do I like doing that so much? Well, you're going to see here in a minute. Now we've crossed off the ones, the twos, the threes, and the fours. Now we're down to a little bitty 5x5 section there. And again, we're on to the fives right now, right? The fives are easy. Anybody can count by fives, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Matter of fact, have them count by fives. And here is a thing that you can tell your student to check their work. The odds, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, they're all going to end in 5. The evens, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, they're all going to end in 0. So all the odds end in 5. All the evens end in 0. 5 times 6 is 30. 5 times 8 is 40. 5 times 10 is 50. And again, I always go back to the middle one. 5 times 5 is 25. And then just have them count by 5s. And once they do that, they've knocked the 5s out. You're going to see that counting by 2s, counting by 3s is something that can ingrain that pattern in their mind. They can recognize it. But I always like to do the plus 3 strategy or plus 4 strategy so they can see you're just adding that number to get the next number. And again, I'll always say what's 5 times 5 because it's the middle one, 25. Once you've done that, you've really, the ones were easy, the twos were easy, the threes were easy, the fours were easy, the fives are easy. Now we are down to a 4x4 square here. And this is all we have to memorize now. How do you learn the nines? Nines are, there's a little bit of a trick to them that's kind of cool. If you do 9 times 1, you've got 9, right? And I put 0, 9 there. But let's look at the next one. 9 times 2 is 18. Well, what's 1 plus 8? It's 9. 9 times 3 is 27. Well, what's 2 plus 7? It's 9. The answer in a multiplication problem, when you multiply a number by 9, the digits add up to 9. 9 times 4 is 36. What's 3 plus 6? It's 9. In other words, if your student is multiplying 9 times 4 and they get an answer where the two digits don't add up to 9, they've done the math wrong. So tell them this is a way to check their work. 9 times 5 is 45. 4 plus 5 is 9. 9 times 6 is 54. 5 plus 4 is 9. 9 times 7 is 63. 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 times 8 is 72. 7 plus 2 is 9. 9 times 9 is 81. 8 plus 1 is 9. And 9 times 10 is 90. And 9 plus 0 is 9. Now, I'm going to show you another thing here on the nines. Look at this. 9 times 2 is 18. The answer is always going to be 1 less than what you multiplied 9 by. You multiplied 9 by 2, what's going to be 1 less? It's going to start with a 1. You multiplied 9 times 3, what's 1 less than 3? It's 2. 9 times 4, what's 1 less than 4? It's 3. It's always, the answer is always going to start with 1 less than whatever you multiplied by 9. 9 times 7 is 63. What is 1 less than 7? It's 6. So you know it's going to start with 6. Now, what else do you know? You know that it's always going to add up to be 9. 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 times 8 is 72. 8, what's 1 less than 8? It's 7. What do you need to add to 7 to equal 9? A 2. It's 72. So nines are real, real easy whenever you understand that the answer is always going to add up to 9. So now you've crossed off the nines, and now you're down to a 3x3 square here. This is really all you got to memorize. Now, people find the squares of numbers sometimes easy. 6 times 6 is 36, 7 times 7 is 49, 8 times 8 is 64. For whatever reason, people just tend to, the kids tend to get those and understand those quicker. So now we're left with 6 answers here, but 3 or 6 different squares, but that's just 3 different multiplication problems. You have 7 times 6 you got to learn is 42. You've got to learn that 6 times 8 is 48, and you have to learn that 7 times 8 is 56. So really those last 3 are really the only 3 challenging ones. But here's the deal. If you're trying to teach a student how to memorize the multiplication tables, break it down by like this and go through each one. And when you go through each one, you're going to end up realizing, hey, this wasn't that difficult at all. But you know what? Learning isn't difficult at all when you approach it in the right direction. That's why I created my Black Belt Memory course. If you click the link down below, you're going to see, I'm going to show you how to dismantle anything you're trying to learn in the same systematic way. What you read, studying for tests, languages, whatever you want to learn, you can learn it faster with my course. Click the link down below. If this multiplication video helped you and helped your kids, I would love the thumbs up. I would really appreciate that. But also comment down below and tell me what you or your kids are working on and studying, and maybe I can help create a video for that. Do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next lesson.